Welcome back to our channel. In last video we have seen net positive suction head and its importance. In this video we will see performance curves of centrifugal pump. So let's start. So, performance curves of centrifugal pumps. These curves are drawn to study or to predict performance of pump other than design conditions. Then in this performance curves there are total three types. First is a constant speed or operating curves. Second is a constant head or main curves, and lastly constant efficiency, or it is also called as a iso efficiency curves. So let's start one by one. So first is constant speed, or it is also called as a operating curves, because we operate pump at constant speeds. So or while operating we maintain speed of pump constant, so it is also called as a operating curves. So under these categories there are total three graphs. First graph is variation of power versus discharge. Second graph we plot, it is variations of overall efficiency versus discharge, and third will be variations of head versus discharge. These curves are obtained by running pump at constant speed and varying heads, varying discharge or pump. So these are the first two graphs, variations of power, that is input power and output power, and variations of overall efficiency versus discharge are shown here. Here it is seen that as discharge is increasing, power is increasing, attains maximum value and goes decreasing. Again, this is the input power. Output power also starts from origin, increases, attains maximum value and decreases. Overall efficiency is also starting from origin, attains maximum value and then decreases. But input power is not starting from origin, it is starting from some non-zero positive value at discharge is equal to zero, increases and then attains maximum value and then starts decreasing. So this initial input power, which is not giving any discharge here, this power is utilized against mechanical losses within pump at start. So this is the input power utilized against mechanical losses. After pump has overcome that mechanical losses, then with increasing input power our discharge is starting, and with starting discharge we get output power, it is water power at outlet. And as we get output power non-zero value, then overall efficiency started. So these are the variations of overall efficiency and overall efficiency and power. Now last curve is to variations of head versus discharge. If you draw, you know that there are three types of vanes are there in case of centrifugal pump. First is a backward curve vanes, that means if this is the direction of flow, the direction of rotation of rotor, then vanes are curved back, or vanes are curved in this manner are called as a backward curve. Then if vanes are not curved back or forth, they are simply radial, then these are called as a radial vanes are there. Then forward curve means if this is the direction of rotation, then vanes are curved in forward direction. So these are the forward curved vanes. Now variations are, as in case of backward curve vent pump, as discharge increases, head or turbine, so head or pump is decreasing. Here for radial, with increasing discharge head is not affected, it remains constant. In case of forward curve, as discharge increases, head or pump is also increases. Then next is a next type of curve is constant head. Next type of curve is constant head curve, or is also called as a main curve. These curves are obtained by running pump at different or various values of speeds. This curve is obtained by changing speed of pump. Then curves of power versus speed, curves of discharge versus speed, curves of head, graphs of head versus speed are drawn. We have for model testing, that is power coefficient, head coefficient and discharge coefficient. Okay, for power coefficient we have relation, power coefficient is P upon N cube reduced to 5 is constant. Head coefficient is H upon N square D square is constant, and discharge coefficient is Q upon N D cube is constant. We have seen these curves in video model testing of pumps, model testing of turbines. I suggest you to please refer that for more details. So here we get that power is proportional to N cube, then head is proportional to N square, and discharge Q is proportional to N. So variations of Q are linear because Q proportional to N here. Then variations of H is parabolic because H is proportional to N square. Then again, lastly, variations of power versus discharge, power versus speed is cubic because P is proportional to N cube here. So these are constant head curves or main curves. Last remaining is iso efficiency curves. These are again derived curves similar to curves in turbines. These are curves are useful for determining or operating pump at constant efficiencies under different head and discharge values. These curves are obtained or derived from curves of head versus discharge and efficiency versus discharge graphs. So if we these curves are drawn in similar manner in that of curves of our turbine, for this we require these two curves, head versus discharge and efficiency versus discharge. From that, if we plot, we get constant efficiency curves are in this manner. So here these are the various values of heads at different constant speed values, and we get here different discharge values. Then suppose, and these lines represents constant efficiency lines similar to graphs in turbine. So if initially our pump is operating, suppose say at this 70% efficiency point condition, and it is giving some head and corresponding discharge. Now if head or pump is increasing, or if we change value of discharge through pump, then what will be the value of head or corresponding discharge to maintain efficiency constant is obtained from this graph. That means if H or pump is changing or discharge is changing, then what will be the corresponding value of head or discharge for that particular value of speed is obtained from these iso efficiency curves. So these are the curves for centrifugal pumps. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please comment on this video, like this video and subscribe our channel. Thank you.